dreamed I went to heaven, and you were there with me. We walked upon the streets of gold beside the crystal sea. We heard the angels singing, and someone called your name. We turned and saw this young man, and he was smiling as he came. And he said, "Friend, you may not know me now." And then he said, "But wait, you used to teach my Sunday."
Woo-hoo! How many of y'all have ever been to a football game? Raise your hand, okay? All right. How many of y'all have ever seen the cheerleaders? Anybody ever seen the cheerleaders? All right. Have you ever? And I don't know if you know this, but a lot of cheerleaders, they do that spirit finger deal, like go team, and they do the spirit fingers, okay? But man, if we get excited about football, and even excited about Tennessee football, we can be excited about Jesus. I want to hear it again, all right? Raise the roof a little bit. Again, if you love the Lord, would you say amen?
Amen.
If you love Jesus, say praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
If you love Him, say oh.
Oh.
If you love Him, say yeah.
Yeah.
If you love Him, say oh yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, give me a J.
J.
E.
E.
S.
S.
U. S.
U. S.
What's that spell?
Jesus.
Who do we love?
Jesus.
Who loves us?
Jesus.
What'd you eat for supper? Oh, no. Somebody almost said Jesus, okay? All right. Well, listen, man, let me have a word of prayer with you, and then I'm going to share some good news, okay? And I'm not going to be real long, because, man, we've got all kinds of things going on tonight. But, hey, I want to share some good news, and then I think we've got a guest coming, okay? He wears a white beard. He wears a lot of red, okay? All right? I'm not really sure if it's Chris Kringle, or I don't know, but anyway, we got a guest coming, and I think we'll give away some backpacks and some other stuff, and so we're going to have a great time together. Let me pray with you guys, and then I'm going to share, okay? So, all right, here we go. Let me pray with you guys, okay? All right, you guys are amazing. All right, let's pray. Heavenly Father, we love you. Thank you for the opportunity we have to, Lord, celebrate your birth. And Lord, thank you for these friends that provided a wonderful meal. Lord, thank you for the opportunity to come together and, Lord, receive a backpack and maybe some other things. Well, Lord, also thank you for the privilege to be able to share some good news. And Lord, in this world in which we live in, there's a lot of sad news and a lot of tragic news. But thank you tonight we can come right here in Tennessee and, Lord, come to a building like this and have fellowship, have something good to eat, have a good time, but also leave here knowing and hearing some good news. So, Lord, bless our time together, and we love you. Thank you for the privilege to be able to share the gospel of Christ. Lord, I pray this, if there's someone here, maybe a mom or dad, Nemaw, Pawpaw, maybe a kid that doesn't have a relationship with Christ, Lord, I pray that tonight will be the night they come to faith in Christ. Lord, we love you. Thank you for loving us. In your name we pray. Amen. Hey, let me ask you this. How many of y'all like good news? Would you raise your hand? All right? All right? Good news. How many of y'all like bad news? Would you raise your hand? Anybody like bad news? There's one little girl right there. Okay, all right? All right? Her dad probably coached her to raise her hand, all right? All right, so tonight I'm going to talk to you about good news, and I'm going to talk to you about bad news, all right? So first of all, let me share some good news, okay? The first thing I want you to know, there's not a mom, not a dad, not a meemaw, not a pawpaw, not a little girl, not a big boy, that God does not love. I want you to know, the Bible says that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him will not perish but have everlasting life. Has anybody ever heard of a guy named Tim Tebow? Tim Tebow played for Florida, and then he played for Denver, and now he's on television every Saturday talking about football games. When he played for, let's see who he played. Blaine went for Florida. He used to wear these big things right under his eyes, these big reflectors. And those reflectors one time said John 3:16. And you know what? Google said that that was the number one Google for that week. Everybody want to know who is John and what is 3:16. Well, again, let me say it for you. And if you've ever been to a NASCAR event, you've ever been to a football game, ever been to a basketball game, then you've ever been to a rodeo, you've had somebody with a t-shirt, somebody with a sign that said John 3:16, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him will not perish, but have everlasting life. So kids, the first thing that God wants you to know is that I love you, that you're special, and I love you. You say, well, man, I'm not sure that anybody really loves me. Some moms may say, I'm not sure that my parents love me, or maybe even my husband always loves me. Or a kid may say, you know what, I'm in trouble all the time, and I'm not sure that anybody really loves me. Well, I want you to know, you are loved. And there's a lot of people that love you, and there's people in this room that love you, but there is a God in heaven, and he says, you are special, and hey, I love you. There's not anybody that God does not love. So the first thing is God loves you. I want you to say that when you say, God loves you. And then say this, God loves me. So the first thing God wants you to know is that there's not a person that God does not love. But hey, I've got some bad news, okay? And I hate to talk about it, but it's really bad news. Second thing God wants you to know is there's not a mom, not a dad, not a kid, not a meemaw, not a papa that has not sinned. The Bible says that all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Now, by the way, what is sin? Really think about that. Well, if I were to go and ask maybe some fifth graders, I said, hey guys, what is sin? Some kid would say, well, sin is when you do something really, really bad, okay? Well, hey, say I run down the street. I'm running, and you know I'm clumsy, and I fall, and I bust my elbows and my knee, and blood is going everywhere. Is that good? No. Is that bad? Yeah. But is that sin? No. Sin is bad, but it's more than just something bad. If I were to talk to maybe some seventh graders, okay, and I said, hey, seventh grade, what is sin? Not just bad, what is sin? They may say, well, sin is when you do something wrong. Well, I want you to know, how about if I said this, what is 2 plus 2? And I said, 2 plus 2 is 5. Is that the right answer?
No.
Is that the wrong answer? But is that sin?
No.
No. Sin is bad. Sin is wrong. But it's more than bad, more than wrong. Sin is when you and I disobey God. So I want you to say that with me. Sin is when you and I disobey God. So if you've ever lied, you've sinned. If you've ever cheated, you've sinned. If you've ever lost your temper, you've sinned. If you've ever said ugly words, you've sinned. Hey, if you've ever stole Halloween candy from your little brother's box, hey, that is a sin. The Bible says that all have sinned. Now, every once in a while, not kids, but adults, I hear an adult say, well, really, I'm not a sinner. I know I've done some bad things, but I've done a whole lot of good things. Well, listen, if we have the withal to look in the face of God and say, God, I am not a sinner, really, we're calling God a liar. Because the Bible says there are none righteous, no, not one. The Bible says all we like sheep have gone astray. In other words, we choose to sin. Sometimes I choose to get angry. I choose to say ugly words. I may choose to be ugly to somebody, like my big brother, okay, all right, that I talked to on the phone today. So listen, the first thing God wants you to know is, hey, there's not a kid, not a mom, not a dad, not a meemaw, not a papa that God does not love. The second thing God wants you to know is there's not a kid, not a mom, not a dad, not a grandparent that has not sinned. The Bible says that all have sinned, even preachers, even, doctors, even folks at the school. Everybody has sinned. And because of our sin, we do not deserve really a relationship with God. And secondly, we really don't deserve heaven. Really, because of our sin, we really deserve separation from God. And that's a place called hell. Now, by the way, don't go around the house saying the word hell, because, by the way, mom and dad will probably freak out, okay? But here's the deal. There's a real place called Tennessee. There's a real place called Florida. And there's a real place called maybe Miami. And there's a real place called Washington, D.C. And there's a real place called Dallas, Texas. And there's a real place called heaven. And there's a real place called hell. And most people I know, even parents, even kids, they don't want to go to hell. They want to be with Jesus. They want a relationship with God. They want their sins to be forgiven. And they want to live with Jesus in heaven for eternity. So the first thing God wants you to know is, hey, I love you. Second thing God wants you to know, hey, you've all sinned. And the wages of our sin, a payment for our sin, is really spiritual death. But there's a third thing. Now, this is good news, okay? So don't get too depressed, okay? This is good. The third thing God wants you to know is there's not a kid, not a mom, not a dad, not a meemaw, not a mom, that Jesus Christ will not save. You say, wait a minute, there's no way that God will ever save me. Man, I've done drugs, I've done alcohol, or man, I've been ugly to my brother, I've been ugly to my kid. Listen, I don't care what you've done. I don't care how many times you've done it. I don't care if you did it last night. Jesus says, I love you, I'll cleanse you, I'll forgive you, and I'll save you. If you'll pray and put your faith and trust in me, repent of your sin, ask God to forgive you, and ask Him to come into your life to be your Lord and be your Savior. We've got some gifts, and we're going to give, not right now, but we're going to give before you leave, and it's a New Testament. We want to give every mom or dad one of these. And here's one of my favorite scriptures in the entire Bible. It's called Romans 10:13. Everybody say that. Romans 10:13. This is what it says, Romans 10:13. It says, for everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. Well, I like that. When it says everyone, or for whosoever, that means anybody. That means, you know, like young people. And that means old people. That means people with hair and people without hair. This means black-headed people and blonde-headed people and big people, little people, people with big ears and people with little baby ears. That means anybody that'll pray, call on the name of the Lord. And the name of the Lord is Jesus. And we ask Jesus to come into our life to be our Savior. That's what Jesus means. We can be saved. Let me share this. We're going to wrap it up. When I was 7 years old, all right, everybody say seven. When I was 7 years old, I realized that I was a sinner. Now listen, at seven, I had never done drugs. I had never done alcohol. I never used ugly language. I was a pretty good kid for a seven-year-old boy. But I'd lied, I had cheated, and I had been disobedient to my mom. And I knew that I had sinned. And I remember going into my dad's office, and I said, Dad, I need to be saved. He said, what'd you say? I said, Daddy, I need to be saved. Well, my dad said, come here. And I ran and I jumped up into a slab. I don't do that anymore because I'm old and I'm big, all right? But hey, I got in a slab. And he said, son, why do you need to be saved? And I said, Dad, I know I've lied. I know I've disobeyed my mom. And I know that I've had a bad attitude. And I know I'm a sinner. And I want to go to heaven. I want to be forgiven of my sin. My dad picked me up. He carried me around a big old desk. Set me down on a little couch in his office. He got down on his big old knees. I got down on my little seven-year-old knees. And he shared that scripture that I just shared with you, Romans 10:13. For whosoever, that means anybody, whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord. The name of the Lord is Jesus. What does Jesus mean? Savior. Will be saved. I want you to know my dad prayed for me. And it was a wonderful prayer. And I remember looking at my dad when he was praying, and tears were coming down his cheeks. Though that was a special prayer, that prayer did not save me. See, I had sinned. I needed God's love. I needed His forgiveness. I needed a relationship with God. So I prayed a prayer like this. Now just listen, I'm almost done. I said, Jesus, I love you. That wasn't a great prayer. I mean, I went to church a lot, but I was seven. I didn't know a lot. I said, Jesus, I love you. Thank you for loving me. Jesus, thank you for dying on the cross for me. Not only did He die, but He's been risen. He's alive and well at the right hand of the Father. I said, Jesus, I love you. Thank you for loving me. Jesus, thank you for dying on the cross for me. Jesus, I am a sinner. Please forgive me for my sin. I was really sorry. Big word we use, repent. That means I was really sorry for my sin. I said, Jesus, come into my heart. Come into my life. And be my Lord. What's that mean, be my Lord? Be my leader, be my boss, be my president, be my king, and be my Savior. You say, what does that mean, Savior? Save me from hell and save me to heaven. You say, Tim, what happened? Nothing weird. I didn't jump up and down. I didn't cry. I didn't laugh. I didn't giggle. I didn't run around the room seven or eight times. But two things happened. Number one, out of peace, that I'd done something pleasing and honoring to God. I knew that God was well pleased with me. Secondly, now listen, this is it. I'm about done. Secondly, I knew if I died when I was 7 or 57 or 77 or 107, my body might go to the grave, but my soul was going to be with Jesus in heaven for eternity. Why
Because I was a good 7-year-old? No. Why? Because I'm a good dad? Well, I try to be. No. Why? Because I try to be a good husband? No. Why? Because I tell people about Jesus? No. Why? Because of the fact that I asked and Jesus said he would do what he said he would do, and that is that he came into my life to be my Lord and be my Savior. So here's the thing, and I'm done. All right, just think about this. Man, are you ready for heaven? You say, well, I hope so. I'm not going to be rude. I'm not trying to be up. You don't need to be hoping when you can be knowing. Are you ready for heaven? Well, I think so. Be honest with you. You don't need to be thinking about it when you can be knowing about it. And the good news is this. You can know that you know that you know for sure that, man, when you die, and that may be 20 years, 50 years, 100 years, or it may be next week, when I die, my body may go in that grave, but my soul is going to be with Jesus in heaven for eternity. By the way, Mom and Dad, let me just be honest with you. Being a Baptist, a Methodist, a Presbyterian, Assembly of God, a Holiness, a Catholic will not get you into heaven. Religion did not die for you. Religion did not raise from the dead. Religion does not have the power to save you, but a holy God does. And his name is Jesus Christ. All right? So hey, being good. There, again, nobody can be good enough to go to heaven. If you could be good enough to go to heaven, why would Jesus have died on the cross for you and for me? I mean, that would make sense. And so the only way for forgiveness is through the Son, Jesus. And ask him and cleanse him to forgive you. Ask him to come into your life to be your Lord and to be your Savior. So here's my question. If you die today, now don't die today. It's not a good day to die, okay? All right? This is not a good. It's cold outside. But if you die today, what would happen? Would you go to heaven? Would you go to hell? Or are you unsure? If you're sitting here saying, I'm really unsure, tonight is the night for salvation. If you're sitting here going, honestly, Tim, I'm not a really terrible person, but I know I'm a sinner, and I've never been forgiven. I've never been saved. I've never asked Christ to cleanse me and forgive me. I would probably go to hell. Tonight is the night to put your faith and trust in Jesus Christ, the Son of God. So listen, right now I can say, hey, peace, love, joy. In a moment, Kris Kringle's coming. We got backpacks. We got all hope. Oh, hey, listen, peace, love, joy. Enjoy Christmas. Hope you enjoyed your meal. But if I did some of you that way, I'd be doing some of you a tremendous injustice. And I'd be doing some of you wrong. So tonight, Mom, Dad, kid, I'm not going to do you wrong. I'm going to do you right. Right there where you're seated. Not back there. Not up here. Not back there. Right there where you're seated. I want to give you an opportunity just to pray. And in that prayer, just talk to the Lord. And just tell him you love him. Thank him for loving you. Thank him for dying on the cross for you. Admit you're a sinner. And by the way, your husband and wife knows you're a sinner. Your mom and dad know you're a sinner. So just be honest about it. God knows you're a sinner. Ask for forgiveness. And then ask Jesus to come into your life to be your Lord and be your Savior. You say, how do you know he'll save me? The Bible says so. Jesus said so. And by the way, if he'll save me, and he'll save this big old dude right here with a big old beard, he'll save you. But here's the kicker. You got to ask. And if you ask and you trust, he'll forgive and he'll cleanse and he'll save. So would you pray with me? Heads are bowed, eyes are closed. Thank y'all for listening. Thank y'all for listening so well. With nobody talking, heads bowed, eyes closed. How many here would say, hey, Tim, I know already that I'm ready for heaven. In other words, if I died tonight, now I don't want to die tonight, but if I did die tonight, this is not a good night to die, but if I were to die tonight, there's no question in my mind, I know that I'm ready for heaven. Not because I'm good, not because I'm religious, not because I have a Bible, but because I have already put my faith and trust in Jesus. If you know that to be a fact, you're not hoping, you're not one, you know that to be a fact, only those that say, I know I'm saved, I know I'm ready for heaven, I want only those that know that to simply quietly raise your hand. Only those that really, really know that. Be honest about it. Don't raise your hand if you don't know. Thank you. You may put your hands down. I want to ask another question. How many others would say, hey, Brother Tim, I'm not sure that I've ever been saved. And by the way, thank you for being honest. Because you could have lied about it tonight. You could have raised your hand and said, oh, yeah, oh, yeah. But you know, and God knows, you're not ready for heaven. So how many others would say, hey, Tim, I'm not sure that I've ever been saved. I'm not sure that I have ever seen my sins forgiven. But I know this. I don't want to die without Jesus. I don't want to die and go to hell. I want God's love. I want his forgiveness. And I would like to have a relationship. I would like to be saved
before it's too late. If that's your story, that's your testimony, right there where you're sitting, I want to encourage you to pray. And I'm going to ask you to pray out loud or nothing like that. But just right there where you're sitting, I encourage you just to pray with me. Now, let me say this when we pray. The prayer doesn't save anybody. And by the way, being baptized doesn't save you either. But the one we pray to, and His name is Jesus, does the saving. So heads are bowed, eyes are closed. If this is your desire to ask Jesus to forgive you of your sin and to come into your heart to be your Savior, then I encourage you to pray with me right now. So just pray. Heads are bowed, eyes are closed. Just talk to the Lord right now. Just say, Jesus. Just pray His name. Jesus, I love You. And I thank You for loving me. Jesus, thank You for dying on the cross for me. Jesus, I realize that I am a sinner. I've lied. I've cheated. I've been disobedient. I have sinned. Jesus, please forgive me for all my sin. Wash me, cleanse me, and forgive me. Jesus, I cannot save myself. So by faith, I ask You, come into my heart, come into my life, and be my Lord, and save me right now. And if you pray that, just thank Him. Say, Jesus, thank You for Your love, for Your forgiveness, and for saving me here tonight. Now, with heads bowed and eyes closed, nobody looking. I heard a few pray, and I think others may have prayed. But I want to ask you this. How many boys and girls, moms and dads, maybe meemaws and pawpaws, would say, Brother Tim, I just prayed with you. And I've never prayed a prayer like that before where I really meant it and where I really understood it. But tonight, Tim, I prayed. And I asked the Lord to forgive me. And I asked the Lord to save me. And I meant that prayer. And I'm really glad that I did. If you prayed with me and you asked Jesus to be your Savior and you're glad that you did, would you just simply lift your hand one last time? Just raise it up high if you prayed with me. Keep it up just for a moment. And I'm going to ask you to give those cards out, okay? And maybe one of our helpers from Georgia may also help, okay? All right, one of our helpers from our church, if you'll help. Man, just keep your hand up, those that prayed with me, okay? Only those that prayed with me, just for a moment. All right, only those that prayed with me. That's awesome. Anyone else? We got two over here, so we need to get these guys right over here. All right, we got two right over here, three over here, actually. All right, so as soon as, quickly as you can, we'll hit these guys. We'll hit them up real good. I mean, hit them, but we'll share with them here. Okay? All right. Here we go, right over here. Brother Pastor, we got three right here, I think. We got two right over here. Okay? All right, that's good. Mom, Dad, we got one over there, I think. All right? Okay. And Pastor, I think we got one right over there. A little blue in the blue right over there. Okay? Alright? Alright. Mom, Dad, if you'll help them, alright, help them fill out this card, that will be awesome. Okay? That will be awesome. Hey, now while you're filling that out, let me say there's a couple of next steps. Number one, if you prayed with me, you need to tell somebody. You need to tell your mom, your dad, your meemaw, your papa. You need to tell your pastor. You need to tell your teachers. Hey, I prayed Wednesday night, and I asked Jesus to be my Savior. And I asked the Lord to forgive me of my sin. So, hey, tell somebody. Number two, you need to, what? Begin to read the Bible and learn about Jesus. And so on the way out, we're going to give you one of these New Testaments. All right? And you can read God's Word and look at John 3:16 or Romans 10:13. And you can find it for yourself, okay? All right? And then I encourage you to go to church. Find a Bible-believing church that preaches the Bible
And we'll love on you, encourage you, where you go and understand what God's Word says, okay? And then, down the road, you need to follow the Lord in believer's baptism. And what does that mean? It's just a picture to the world of what Christ has done for you and what Christ can do for others, okay? All right, so we'll give you just a moment to fill those out, and then, man, we'll be about done with me, okay? All righty. Did anybody else pray that we have missed? I don't want to miss anybody. Any young men, moms, dads, meemaws, papaws? Okay. And by the way, if you enjoyed the chicken and the mac and cheese and the green beans and the mashed potatoes and the cookies and the rolls, would you let these friends that provided that give them a big round of applause? All right, would you do that? Let them know, man, that we appreciate that and how good it was. All right. All right. Anybody else? When you're done filling that out, just raise up your card, and they'll come by and pick up that card, okay? All right. You guys are amazing, okay? All right. All right. I think we're almost done. Man, you guys are great. By the way, I'll be hanging out around. If you got questions, you're like, man, I didn't pray. I don't know. But I got a question or two. I'll hang out, okay? And you just come talk to me, and I'll do my very best to explain, okay? All right, so before we turn it over to our next part of the program, I want to hear it one more time. If you love God, will you say amen?
Amen.
Oh, man, that's weak. Come on, man. Come on, Tennessee people. If you love God, say amen.
Amen.
If you love Him, say praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
If you love Him, say oh.
Oh.
If you love Him, say yeah.
Yeah.
If you love Him, say oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
Again, give me a J.
E.
S. U. S. What's that spell?
Jesus.
Who do we love?
Jesus.
Who loves us?
Jesus.
What'd you eat for dessert?
Jesus.
All right, okay, all right. Hey, give our Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ, a big we love you. Give Him a big round of applause, okay? Thank you so much, and praise the Lord, okay? I'm going to turn it over to those who are in charge, okay? All right, anybody else? You got your card?
I am a life that was changed. Thank you for giving to the Lord. I am so glad you gave. Then another man stood before you and said, remember the time missionary came to your church. His pictures made you cry. You didn't have much money, but you gave it anyway. Jesus took the gift you gave, and that's why I'm here today. Thank you for giving to the Lord. That was changed.